Hello everyone and welcome to Maple Leaf ESL. My name is Andrew and thank you for joining me here in the classroom today. For today's lesson, I want to take a look at baseball idioms, okay? So for this lesson, I've chosen 7 idioms. All of them are baseball related and we're going to take a look at a lot of different examples, okay? So let's get started here. So the first one says here to drop the ball. And the definition is to make a mistake or to blunder, okay? And just remember, to blunder means to make like a stupid mistake, okay? All right, imagine this. I have to make a presentation, so I prepare for it. I do a great job preparing for it. And then on the day of the presentation, I bring the wrong presentation, okay? So I can say here, I really dropped the ball in this situation, right? Because again, I made sort of a stupid mistake, right? It was something really dumb. Okay, one more example. Imagine there's a woman, I really like her, right? So I want to talk to her and I want her to like me. Okay, but I've got a drink in my hand and then I accidentally spill the drink all over her dress. Okay, so I really dropped the ball here, right? So again, I kind of made this blunder, right? Sort of a stupid mistake, so I dropped the ball, okay? All right, next one says to hit a home run, and the definition is to succeed at something, okay? All right, this one's pretty simple, right? I think most people know what a home run is, right? That's when you hit the ball over the fence, okay? So again, let's think about a presentation, okay? Now, imagine I make this presentation and everybody loves it, okay? My boss loves it, everyone. So I can say I really hit a home run with my presentation, right? So anytime you hit a home run, it means you do something really well, okay? So if you have a job interview and you do well at the job interview, you can say I hit a home run on my job interview or at my job interview. All right, next one says out of left field, and this is a really common expression. It says here suddenly or from somewhere unexpected, okay? All right, imagine my friends and I were sitting around and we're talking about movies. Just having a casual conversation, right? Nothing special. And then one friend, he makes a comment about something from 10 years ago, some little story. And it's not related to our conversation about movies at all. So we can say his comment was really out of left field, right? Again, it came from just somewhere unexpected. It was just all of a sudden. We didn't expect him to talk about that. And you know, it wasn't related to what we were talking about. So it came out of left field, or it was out of left field, right? So anything, something happened suddenly or unexpectedly, especially when it's a little strange, we can say it's out of left field or it came out of left field. Next one there says to throw someone a curveball. Okay, this is another really common expression. It says to surprise or confuse someone. All right, think about this. Imagine I'm really looking forward to the weekend, right? I got a lot of fun things planned for the weekend. Okay, and then my boss says, I want everybody to come and work on the weekend, right? Saturday and Sunday, we need to work all day. Okay, so the boss really threw us all a curveball, right? So she really surprised us with this information, right? We didn't think we were coming in on the weekend, so she threw us all a curveball. Okay, one more example. Imagine I have an exciting vacation planned with one of my friends, okay? And we're really excited about it. We talk about it every day. And then a couple days before the vacation, my friend says, sorry, I can't go, right? I don't wanna go with you anymore. Maybe he's angry or I don't know. So my friend threw me a curveball, right? He kind of surprised me that he canceled this vacation because we were so excited, right? So I'm a little confused, I'm a little surprised. So he threw me a curveball. Okay, next one says a ballpark figure, okay? And the definition is an estimate or a guess. And we could also say a ballpark estimate, right? So a ballpark figure or a ballpark estimate. Okay. If I ask my friend, how many people were at the concert that you went to, okay? And my friend says, I have no idea. And I say, I don't need to know the exact number of people. Just give me a ballpark figure, right? So my friend says, oh, maybe 5,000 people, right? So that's an estimate, that's a guess. He gave me a ballpark figure, right? Okay, one more example. Imagine, I want to know how much a company makes in a year. Like, oh, I wonder how much money McDonald's makes in a year. So my friend says, I don't know, but I could probably give you a ballpark figure, right? So he means I could probably guess, right? I might not be exactly correct, but I'll be close, right? So again, a ballpark figure. It's just an estimate or a guess, usually for an amount or a dollar amount, something like that. Okay, couple more. Next one says right off the bat, and the definition is immediately or instantly. Okay, imagine, when I meet a person for the first time, let's imagine I meet this guy, Chris, okay, and very quickly, Chris and I become friends, right? We really like each other. So I can say, right off the bat, Chris and I became friends, right? So instantly, we became friends. Okay, one more example. Imagine two people, so they're gonna do some business together. Okay, usually, when you sit down for business, it's pretty common to have a little bit of small talk, right? How you doing? You know, how's the weather? How's your family? Just a little bit of small talk before you start talking business. Okay, but imagine this one guy, he just starts talking business immediately, right? He doesn't say, how are you doing, or you know, what's new? He just starts talking business right off the bat, we can say. So he starts talking business instantly, right? Right off the bat. Okay, one more, and it says to go to bat for someone. And the definition there is to support or help someone. Okay, imagine my friend gets in trouble with the police, okay? The police, they think he did something bad. Okay, and I know this friend of mine, and I know he would never do this bad thing, okay? So I might go to the police and I might say, no, my friend didn't do it, right? And I'm really supporting him. So in this situation, I'm going to bat for my friend, okay? Another good example, think about an election, okay? Think about in the United States. Okay, they're gonna have a presidential election, and maybe there are two main people who could become the new president. Okay, usually when this happens, you see other like famous people or maybe former presidents who go to bat for one of those candidates. Maybe the former president supports this candidate. So the president will go to bat for that person, right? So this means they're gonna say some nice things about the person. They might go on TV or on the radio and say positive things about that person. So they're going to bat for that person, right? So they're supporting them. Okay, let's see if we can erase the whiteboard, and I wanna take a look at some written examples using each of these baseball idioms. All right, the first example here says, I totally dropped the ball at my audition, right? Remember, an audition is when you're trying out for something. Like, usually it's like a theater play or maybe for a musical band, right? That's an audition, so I dropped the ball at my audition, so I made some stupid mistake. Okay, Amy hit a home run on her science test yesterday, right? So she was really successful on her science test, right? She got a good score. Next one, the reporter's comments sort of came out of left field. She doesn't usually say stuff like that, right? So maybe this reporter, she usually says stuff like this, but today she made comments that were very different from her usual comments. So her comments came out of left field, right? They sort of surprised everyone. Okay, next one. My girlfriend threw me a curveball when she broke up with me yesterday, right? So I was really surprised when she broke up with me. I was not expecting this, so she threw me a curveball. Next one. How much will this cost? Can you give me a ballpark figure? Okay, so again, can you give me an estimation, right? Can you guess how much this will cost? Next one, we got along right off the bat and have been best friends ever since. Right? So we got along immediately or instantly and have been best friends ever since. Okay, and last one, you're lucky to have so many great friends who will go to bat for you. Okay, so you're lucky to have so many great friends who will support you and who will help you. All right, that is the end of today's lesson. I hope you enjoyed taking a look at all of these baseball idioms. Thank you so much for joining me here at Maple Leaf ESL, and I look forward to seeing you again next time.